I'm on the move, which is never good because the light will keep changing. And welcome to another weekly vlog. I forgot to get my tablets. I've just finished filming what I watched for last week. Where's my tablets? Oh, Jesus, don't keep piling things up on top of my bloody vitamins. This is my little vitamins for the day. So, yeah, just finished filming what I watched for last week. I watched a really funny one last night called Boys from County Hell, which is set in Northern Ireland. And I really, it's like a comedy horror. I really enjoyed it. Ooh, that's a nice red Jeep out there. I wouldn't mind one of that. So next door had the police out last night. Did I tell you that they were stealing her oil? And they stole, and she's like, yes, I did, because I remember filming it. That was last week, right? So you don't need to know that this week. So it is 3 o'clock. Just waiting on Isaac getting back. Hope he's had a good day at school. See how much work they've given them to pile through, which, I'm not even going to get started. It really aggravates me that they give them all this work, which takes away from time they could be preparing for the transfer test. Then he needs to try and get some guitar fitted in. It's a lot to do, isn't it, Dobby? It's a lot to do. There she is. Hello, Dobby. Had a good care. Have you been a walk? You have been a walk, haven't you? Yes, you. Oh, she's so good. I'm just a walking post in this house. Now she's... Are you deliberately turning away from the camera so I can't film? Hello. What are you doing? Is Isaac coming? Can you see him? Do you even know what that means? I don't think you do.
I don't think you do.
There she is. Look at her little dots on her chest. Her hair sort of like grows back sporadically and sheds as well, but there's nothing wrong with her, the vet says. It's just, she has got a really thin layer of hair at the minute on her chest, you can see, but it's not as thick as everywhere else. Molly's having a little sleep there. She will be up when Isaac comes back. Oh, you're standing on my hair, Dobby. You are. There. Are you going to settle yourself there till Isaac comes home? And then you're going to do some barking? Yes, you are. So, nothing to tell you folks. This is way too close, but what can I do? Monday, I need to get on that exercise bike today and get something. I only lost 1 pound last week. But I did have a bowl of ice cream last night as a treat for my anniversary. So, 1 pound off this way. At least it's off. At least it's coming off. So that's 10 pounds altogether now, which is another couple of weeks. Hopefully it'll be a stone, which is awesome. Just another like 3 to go. Right. Okay, I'll go. I'll catch up with you later. Look at this. Waiting.
I bought a movie just yesterday.
I'm watching. I'm Kelly. Is doing the top 10 movie tag. Well, at least you remembered. I wouldn't flippin' remember. Just pause this so I can watch it. Yes, is Isaac coming? I'm sorry, but this amuses. Hello, Dobby. She's such a fun. I'm not going to film her. She puts her tail up. You'll be able to see her bum. You don't want to see the dog's bum, do you? Hello, doggies. Hello. I'm excited because Isaac's coming home. She just woofed at Molly. Oh, they make me laugh. They really do. Look at this lovely Jeep outside. I'd love one of those. Isn't that lovely? Now, no sign of them coming yet. Just looking up there.
Hello. Too young to drive so fast. She never heard me calling you from the past. Couldn't catch you falling. Late to say goodbye. I never heard you leaving, God knows that I've tried to save your heart from bleeding. At the end of the rainbow, the colors are fading. Oh, I would have killed to have you back. Yeah.
Put it on to show you my new lump in its place. Might bring this round to the front a bit, because it's got... How autumn is that? Oops. You can take the light down a bit. Hang on. So I'm moving this so I can dull it down a bit. I can switch it to any colour I want. Awesome. Can't see what colours I'm choosing because I'm in the dark. I'm going to keep it on white because it looks like the moon. Yeah. Hello, it is Tuesday. Let me just pause this. Sorry, mute this. I usually switch this on when Darren's going to get Isaac from school. So, Darren's going to get Isaac from school. I am currently editing my what I watched for last week, and then at some stage I need to edit last week's vlog. My mum's just called. My dad had his second COVID jab yesterday and he is really not well at all today. He's got migraine headache, hurts head to foot, so he's in bed. Obviously when you have other conditions on top, you know, I know a lot of people say, oh, it's not that bad, but my dad has fibro and arthritis and just is not a well man normally, so he's struggling. He's in bed at the minute. I'm going in to the opticians on Friday. On Friday, this Friday the 30th, stuff opens up here like it did in England like 2 weeks ago. Well, it'll be 2 weeks sort of Monday, I think. So like our shops, I'm not sure how many open, to be honest, because I'm just completely confused by the whole thing, because all the different parts of the UK are doing different things at different times, and we always get what England are doing here, even though it's not relevant to us, which I don't get. So it's really confusing for people. But I know most stuff opens on the 30th, including the zoo, which we're going to the week after. But at the minute, no, apart from the opticians and it drop in to see my mum. And still, I've told you this ages ago, so you'll probably sort of think, my God, Lisa, that was ages ago. My mum gets her benefit paid to a post office account, but it all had to be switched to a bank account. So if you remember back to then, and that has been switched over, but the money that's left in the post office account, they're frozen and they won't give her. So you have to like send away to their head office this form, an account closure form, to transfer the remaining funds into your bank account. First time we did it and posted it, oh, well, we don't have it. Second time, Darren took it physically into the post office, handed over the counter, watched the woman stamp it. It's in, it's there. They still haven't had their money, and that was weeks ago. So I'm just sick and tired of, well, we haven't received it. See, if you don't send things recorded, they never seem to receive it. These people are just useless. Never have any sort of savings account in the post office. They are crap. They must give their staff no training in those places, honestly. I've had so many problems. But I'm going to have to go in on Friday. But mum and dad can't deal with things like this themselves. They're just not used to doing it. So when I'm in on Friday, I'll have to phone them again. And I know when I phone, they're going to say we don't have the form. And no amount of me saying, well, it was handed over the counter in the post office to be sent via internal mail, and it was stamped in front of us, that's not going to matter to whoever we speak to on the phone. So I'm going to have to go get another post office closure form, get it completed again, and all the while, any money that's in that account, they're making money from, and my mum doesn't have. And my mum can't afford to not have her money. You know, it's disgusting. So when I get this next one, and I get the address it needs to be sent to, there's going to be a very scathing letter of complaint that goes with it, and it's going via recorded delivery. I'm just scunnered with them. I really am. I don't think there's anything really else to tell you. We had our anniversary a couple of days ago. It'd be nice to be able to have like a nice meal or something. But obviously we can't. So my mum gave us money, bless her. She, you know, I don't know why. And Kelly gave us money as well. As spoiled rotten. So what I think we're going to do is, when things open, obviously a romantic meal with Isaac, because my parents just aren't up to looking after him. They would take him for a couple of hours. I know they would, but I don't feel right doing that. So what we're going to do is maybe go for a nice meal in like a nice pub when things open again. It may be, I don't know, Dobby. It may be a couple of months. I don't know how long it's going to be, but when it happens, we're going to have a nice pub meal as a belated anniversary. Will you stop licking my mouth? Is Isaac coming? Is Darren going to get Isaac? Are you looking forward to seeing Isaac? Are you? She's looking for him now. Is he coming? Where have they gone? Have they gone? Oh, now Molly's over. Molly? Where's he gone? Is Isaac coming? Is he? Are you going to look for Isaac? Where's he gone? Look at them waiting for Isaac. You want to see them from the front if I move this? Hang on. Waiting on Isaac. Is it home time? Are we going to see Isaac? Oh dear me. Right, I'm going to go and try and get this bloody editing finished. I'll check in with you later.
Dobby. Dobby. What are we doing there?
Hello. It is Wednesday. Here come the girls. Do you want to know why the girls are coming? I'm having my breakfast. I'm having some raisin and cinnamon toast and a fruit pot with apple, strawberries, raspberries, and a few grapes. And you're not having any. So I heard. Oh, the postman might be here. Oh, crap. Right, the postman's here and we've missed it. And Molly's got it, whatever it is. Naughty dog.
Previous tenant.
Right, it's only crap. What if that had been something important? She ragged Isaac's past test paper that he had to bring home from school and correct last week. I'm sat surrounded by papers. They're at guitar practice last week and I'm sat going through it. Door goes. She picks up the paper and shakes it all around the place. Right, so anyway, I'm gonna go and enjoy my toast before it goes cold. I'll check in later. Isaac's just been for his guitar lesson and he got on well. I've shown him the rest of Hey Joe. I don't know how he remembers it. But in the midst of starting his practice today, next door came. And it's the mum's birthday. So we have all got, look at how gooey that looks. We have all got a slice of cake. Isaac says it's very nice. I haven't had any. I shouldn't really not be having it, but what can you do when the person gives you a slice of cake? But eat it. I'm not complaining. They got their first literacy test today, you know, the transfer test things. And one of the little lads in the school has got the same test at home. Those people are practicing papers at home, and he got 90-odd%, which was like 20% more than anybody else in the class. Because he's got the paper. So I tell you what, see if these marks are used to decide anything. I'm going to be not best pleased. Isaac doesn't do very well on literacy or comprehension. And I don't know why, because to me the answers are all there in front of you. But one of the headmaster, now I don't know if this is Isaac talking out his arse or if this is true. The headmaster told them to basically not to read the passage. So he said, don't read the passage because you won't have time. Look at the questions and skim the work for the answer. And it's like, no, because some of the questions you need the context of the passage to answer. So he's not been reading it, he's been skimming it. And I don't know if he's been told that or if he's saying he's been told that. But the comprehension most definitely needs work. What was it? He's 51% or something, which his potential is way bigger than that, but we're just going to have to work on it. And Some kids just, it's this thing, when I was at school, I was a person that loved tests, and I know there are people like me, we're few and far between, but some children just don't enjoy sitting down and doing a test. They get stressed or they rush. Isaac rushes and finishes too early, and he even is told to go back and check his answers, and obviously given the way his paper came home, he hasn't. So it's telling him, take the time, read the passage, because most children at this stage, from like websites I'm on and stuff, or like a Facebook page of other parents whose kids are preparing, and they've said that their kid doesn't get enough time to finish. They're really struggling to finish. And I'm like, yeah, well, because they're probably doing what you should do, which is read the passage. And the speed builds as you practice, but Isaac's just rush, 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 and not reading properly. So we need to... The dog... Right, look at Dobby. Can you see it? There she is. Look. There is a piece of cake on the end of that table. You can probably just about see. It's Darren's. He doesn't want it because he shouldn't really be eating cake because he gets bloat. But now she's not going to do it to make the light. Look, 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 look. She's seen the cake. She knows it's there. She's watching it. Is that cake, Dobby? Is that your cake? I'm afraid you're not having any of that. No. Molly's trying her best.
Yeah, she is.
To get round him. It's cake, Daddy. She says, cake. Now she's spotted mine. Greedy dogs. Hello. Better turn that down. It is Thursday night. Darren and Isaac are at where's the remote control? Darren and Isaac are at Gaelic practice. They should be back any minute. It's a really nice day, but Isaac has still got some reading. It's just, oh, the amount of work they give them to do, especially in this good weather, is just not conducive. I was on one of the Facebook support groups for the 11 plus last night and found out that most parents are doing, on top of their homework, an additional 1 hour's practice paper per evening, Monday to Friday as a minimum, making the kid just go over a different paper every night. And I'm thinking, oh my god, we've been like, I thought we were sort of ahead of the thing by starting to go through them at all, because at school they haven't told us to. And I went through one over the past week with them, like maybe 20 minutes a night, 15 minutes a night. But these kids are doing an hour every night on top of their homework, which basically would mean Isaac would come home from school, he'd do his homework, then it would be tea time. He would struggle to fit in half an hour practice on guitar, which he has to do as a minimum. He then has to do half an hour's reading for school, and then if you put on top of that another hour's past paper, then it's bedtime. It's too much. It's way too much. But I don't know. I'm getting too caught up in it, but I just worry. Anyway, nothing happening. I've got an optician's appointment tomorrow, contact lens check and eye test. So I'll take you with me in the car tomorrow afternoon, and then I'm just gonna call in on my mum. But besides that, not to tell you. I'll catch up with you later. It is Thursday night. We're just taking Isaac to bed.
Look at the cloud over there. It looks like a lizard.
He's just look at the way the light is hitting the hills tonight. You can't really pick it up on here, but there's like a real glow.
It's like orange.
Yeah. So.
Is this coincidence? There's an ink mark in the shape of a heart.
It's coincidence. Right, come on. Now, let me see if I can actually show you this.
What?
I don't know if I can or not. Right, it's bedtime for any self-respecting child of Isaac's age. I'm going to try and be...
I see your name.
Nope, everyone's... 2 minutes ago, there were about 10 children there. From everywhere. Look at the cat opposite the road in the window. Nope. None of them there. Thank God for that. They've all gone home, finally.
The cat's looking at us.
I thought that's going to be screeching while you're trying to... Right, into bed.
The cat's looking at us. Stevens, go, go, go!
Look, this room was tidy until Darren got all his crap in it. Honestly. Can't have been nothing in this flippin' house.
Mum.
What?
Need to run. Cat's lost.
Right. Let's finish this book that you picked.
Yeah.
That you will have an AR test on in school tomorrow. Right, and well, you've got toothpaste on your pyjamas. Right, bed please. Hello! It is Friday. I'm on my way to the optician's. And then I've got a few little things to do. Go and see my mum, drop off some stuff for her. Then I need to go and pick up a scooter we got for Isaac. All the kids in the area are riding about on scooters, so he still got his birthday money and he had £30 vouchers for Smith's. So I ordered him a scooter online last night. I need to go and collect that. Shop's open today, I suppose, is the main reason I'm putting this on to tell you. So yeah, we're 2 weeks behind everyone else. Well, 2 weeks behind England, further behind, I think Wales was first. So yep, shop's open today. It's just completely coincidental that my optician's appointment's today, because I really would rather not have been going into town on the day that the shop's open, because I dread to think it's going to be so busy trying to get parked. Don't think, I'll not keep you waffling, because literally there's nothing. I make these videos too long by talking at you. I will go and listen to some, what have we got, Pink, I think? Yep, right. That's rocking, isn't it? Don't care, I like Pink. Right, shall see you later. To see if it's busy. So it's a bit boring, it's just a little town centre for the next little bit. Are you going to cross? Are you going to cross? Are you going to cross? No, you're not going to cross. No. Sorry, I need to stop singing when I've got this turned down. Like, it's impossible. Wobbling a lot, sorry guys. A lot of cars parked on the sides of the roads. Right at the bottom of this hill, if you can see a massive red brick building up on the hill, that is my old secondary school, grammar school. such a cruddy little street. Right ahead of us is the car park for the shopping centre that I want to go into, that's got the Opticians in it. Boots Opticians. There's also a multi-story which I really don't want to have to go into. I want to park in front of us in this little car park, but I'm feeling it might not be possible. Oh god, yeah, it's busy compared to normal. I'm sure this is highly exciting for you guys. I'm just gonna pass Isaac's guitar place. And just around this corner, you'll maybe see the guitar and see it. That's where Isaac learns guitar. I'm gonna put the window down and get me a ticket. And keep your fingers crossed for me. Oh, there's a parking space, there's a parking space. There's one. Thankfully, because I have my disabled badge, I can park in the disabled space. Now this guy, I need to go right where he is right now. People always stare at me when I do this, like, how dare you park in a disabled space? It's like, yeah love, I've got a disability, it's fucking get used to it. Right, and it's not my husband. Right, so I'm here, it's lovely, it feels like a lovely day even though it's only 11 degrees Celsius. Very busy, thankfully I can, actually let me move this so it's visible. Quick flash. If you aren't a normal person that watches this, as in if you don't normally watch this, not if you're not a normal person, I've got fibro and ME, which is why I've got the badge. I don't like to use it if I can help it, but if there's only one space in the car park that will prevent me having to go up a multi-story and knacker my hips and knees, I'm taking it, I'm afraid. Right, mask. I have to wear a mask at all times in the Opticians. Right, I'm off to the Opticians. We've got a special queue for Primark. What is the big attraction with Primark, folks? Really? B&M's where it's at. Piccadilly Junction, trying to follow these bloody... that's that done. Two things. Well, my eyesight's fine. Don't need any increase of magnification. The eye health is fine. That was a really thorough eye test. They shone lights in my eyes while I was looking every direction you can imagine. It is so warm in this car. Oh my god, it's 21 degrees. Flippin' hell. Was it when I went in there? I keep forgetting I've got that thing where I've got like a screen where I can look at and see if there's anything behind me, but I'm sorry, but I don't trust it. So I came out to my car in the blistering heat. One of my friends just texted me, "I see you." I'm like, "Where is she?" And I'm looking all around, but I didn't have my sound on because I was in the opticians, and I didn't have my data on, which I just switched on so that I could, I only ever use Wi-Fi, I never use data. Because, oh, there's my old surname on that, McQuillan. McQuillan Cleaning Services. I've been considering taking my name back as a double barrel. I wanted to do it when I got married, but I thought my surname, McQuillan, and Darren's Davey, just sounded like a mouthful, like McQuillan Davey. But I feel really sad to have lost my name. And I think Isaac looking so much like his dad's side and nothing whatsoever like me. I almost feel like my family, everything's dying off, you know what I mean? Like, I've lost my name. My son doesn't look anything like me. He has his dad's name, obviously. If I had had it like a short name, you know, like a one syllable, even a two syllable name. But McQuillan, you know what I mean? It's long. Like if I'd have been called Smith, Davy Smith, Smith Davis, Davy Smith. Oh, that one's out again, which means I have to go across. Oh, this is a fucking nightmare. Last time I made a right arse of this last time. Right, do you want to see me make an arse or something? Right. See where the blue car's going? That's the, see the way the guy in front of me is doing really weird maneuvers? That's because to get to that thing from here is really difficult maneuver. And then you, the ignorant fuckers that are coming out of there won't let you in. So I can't tell you how bad I messed this up last time. Alright, that BMW is obviously, look, you see now. Oh, wait, fucking hell, this is fucking reversing at me. You see what I mean? You can't do it in one maneuver. It's impossible. I don't even know if you can hear me. There's a guy sitting having his lunch. He's having a bottle of, what's that? BPM energy drink. You see, she's had to open the door. It's completely, it's so difficult to do this maneuver and not have to take your seatbelt off and open your door, which she's just had to do. Right, is there nothing coming this way is the problem. Right, Nissan, you can wait. Right, let's see how far can I get from it. Oh my god, Lisa, you're a fucking genius. You are a fucking genius. First time. No maneuvers required. Jesus Christ. But I'm seriously impressed by myself there, folks, I have to say. So I'm going to collect this scooter now for Isaac. And then I'm going up to my mum's. Anyway, I didn't tell you. Car park. Got to the fucking thing where you pay for the car park, which was £1. It's usually 50p. I must have been in there quite a while. And it doesn't take notes, and I only had like 50p in change, and it was £1, so I had to walk all the way, but no shops open, you know, it's like the big shops are open today, like did you see the queue? I didn't film on the way back, but the queue for Primark was just ridiculous. There were three separate queues for Primark. Where are you going? Where are you going? Right, that person obviously didn't do what I did. They were in the wrong lane, and they should have switched across to my lane. They didn't switch, but they've just decided to come across this way anyway. Smiths. So I had to go all the way back to the tower centre because there's like a machine in there that takes notes. Fucking nightmare. Right, off to pick up this scooter malarkey. I had to switch my data on because they have to have a barcode that they have to scan when you pick something up. And I need to have photographic ID ready as well. honestly. Right, look at this, come on. Move. I've gone the wrong fucking way! That's just right, I'm going to, people's going to think there's something wrong with me. I'm going round the roundabout just for the value of it. I was meant to go where that bus went, but I got really distracted by the bus. Oh, I'm an idiot. Right, there. Have we done it this time, Lisa? Have we done it? And we're only a car behind the bus. Oh, it's busy down here. Sainsbury's is off that way, you see. The range was... I don't know why so many people are always in the flipping range. Hello! On my way back home, scooter picked up. Got myself a little Freddie Mercury pop that was sitting behind beside the counter in Smith's. Right, what am I going to listen to cheer myself up? This one always works, I don't know why. Desperate to get round a tractor. He's got about four cars in front of him and he's looking to overtake. Really? Groats on the corner that are always doing stuff they shouldn't. Right, I'm almost home, so I shall switch off. So I'm back in the house. Doggies are pleased to see me. This is Isaac's scooter. Light's not very good. So I have to, I'm assuming, put this together. Yes, it's got my name on the side because I booked it. And I treated myself to, yes, that's my third pop now, my third Freddy pop. Awesome. That's not yours, that's mine. It's mine. Right, so let's have a go at putting this bad boy together so we can use it this evening. Right, let's put Freddy with the other Freddies. I really shouldn't have tried to do this with one hand. Right, so it's not one of the ones with the little stand, so hopefully he'll stand nicely. Right, guitar bag on the floor. Honestly, this is like a little hidey hole for all this crap. Right, so we'll put Brian up along with the other two. We'll reserve the front for Freddy. Let me fiddle these so that we can see them a bit clearer. Oops. Alright, there we go. So the only Freddy I've left to get that I want is the one with the crown and the cloak. Yeah.
Hello, it is Saturday. Darren has gone into town to get a prescription that I forgot to collect for him yesterday because I'm a numpty. He's taken Isaac with him. So I've just had like an hour of nobody bothering me. So I've recorded a couple of videos that I needed to do, a couple of reaction videos and a contest entry video. And then I'm just updating you with the fact it's Saturday. I'm sat on my arse and yeah, the boys will be back soon. I'm going to edit these couple of videos and hopefully get them up. Nothing new happening. Went to see my mum yesterday. My dad's doing a lot better after his second COVID jab. He's going to see Status Quo, or should I say half of Status Quo, in January next year with my aunt. So that'll be good. It'll get him out. My dad never goes anywhere. It's like, oh, well, I told her I'd have to check with you to see if you could come home and sit with your mum. I'm like, well, why would you have to check? Just say yes. Oh, no, I could never presume. I'm like, of course I can come in. So it's good that he's going to get to go see that next year. We've booked Iron Maiden for June next year, I believe, for Isaac's first gig. It's outside, it's an open air one, it's somewhere I've never been. I'm a little bit nervous because I don't like crowds. I know this sounds ridiculous. I'm not a fan of, like, you wouldn't get me standing at an arena concert that was full because I get too nervous. When The Darkness played Manchester, I was in the second row from the front in the middle, and I had to leave after like one song because everybody was crushing forward and I get so nervous. I prefer to be seated if I can help it, which is better for my joints as well. But if it's like a small venue, like that holds, I don't know, like Rock City, I suppose isn't that big a venue, but I'm comfortable there in that sort of size. But or Backyard Babies, I'm at the front row, I don't care where I'm at, but it's always somewhere small with Backyard Babies. Anyway, I'm getting distracted. All's well, nothing much to report.
Hello, it's Sunday, it's that time. It is root time, look at them grey hairs. So I'm gonna dye the old hair. I've got the old, look at this, the old hair hair dyeing vest on. I don't usually have to do this bit, but all of this will need doing. Oh, it's shocking getting old, folks. So yeah, let's get started with the old dyeing. So I forgot to close off the vlog, didn't I? It's Sunday night. I'm going to my bed. Your roots are dyed. So thank you for watching this week. Next week we have the zoo on Saturday. Thank you for watching. Over and out from Kitten Kaboodle.